Hi everyone, how's it going? This is Ash and welcome to my latest model train review to come in June 2014. Now, this is a review of another Class 60 that I've acquired since I've reviewed my ever-growing fleet of Hornby Class 60s. I believe this could be either the 19th or the 20th Class 60 to join my fleet. But I may have more, I may have less, as most of them are stored at the moment. But I do have another EWS one that I will be reviewing, and also one that I will be covering that I've had since 2006, as that one has been overlooked. This model is not the actual Hornby model that was released in 2008, although this one is 60029. But this is a code 3 renumber. Also, the nameplates, which is Clitheroe Castle, are etched. And also, this model has had some enhancements to make it more lifelike. So, without further ado, let's take the model from the box and let's see what we get inside. Besides the locomotive, of course. Due to the way this tray has been reformed, the top bit just lifts off and the whole tray just collapses to a three part that's held together with tape. And also, this model, although I'm in the process of removing the rear air dam, I have painted the buffers black on this model, as these buffers were bare metal, which in my opinion doesn't look as nice. I'll show you the progress that I've done so far, as this model was detailed at both ends, but I would like 60029, this variant of the model, to be able to haul wagons and rolling stock. So once I find a semi-transparent air dam for the rear, I will be removing this and using a tension lock coupler. If not, I will have to take out some modifications on this full air dam at cab number 2 end, as this is the rear of the locomotive. Also, you may have noticed this model does have light weathering. Right, I'm just going to briefly pause the video, as this will give me some time to get rid of the packaging and also to set up the locomotive on the dynamos, of which I will test the handling as well as you will see the head and tail lights in action. And just like with my last three reviews, I will also switch the locomotive around to show both sides. So, I'll be back in a moment, stay tuned. Now that I have the locomotive set upon the dynamos, I would like to give a shout out to one of my subscribers, whose name is Nathan Lawrence, as this one is his favourite diesel locomotive. And as such, I thought hence the mention. But let's crack on with the review, and I'm going to run the locomotive in the forward direction. I will be putting a driver and a second man into this locomotive, as it does need a crew, and this trend dates back from around January when I started rolling out fitting crews into my locomotives. I still have quite a bit of my collection to treat in this way, although due to my planned future layout, which sadly now won't be for at least another 18 months, as I'm kind of back to square one, I am going to have a marshalling yard where some of these diesel locomotives will be stored out of service. So, although a good percentage of my model trains will have a crew in the cab, but this won't apply to all of them, as having a driver in every single locomotive parked up in the diesel depot would look somewhat unrealistic. As you can see, this model of the Hornby Class 60 is a very smooth runner. The benefits are clearly shown with the additional two dynamos, or rolling roads as they are known, as these Hornby Class 60s are quite heavy. In addition to what I mentioned about modifying the cab number 2 end of this locomotive, I might vouch for a wire loop coupler instead, as then I can have the full air dam, and this model of 60029 will be able to haul rolling stock. Also, for those of you interested in the prototype information, this locomotive is no longer with EWS, also known as DB Schenker, as this was part of the deal of the all 20 locomotives that were up for sale being bought by Colas Rail. And the first one to make its debut is 60087. Although I'm not going to ruin any surprises right now, but I will be getting a Colas Rail Class 60, as I do like their livery, and it kind of reminds me of the old load haul livery in some ways, minus the lime green yellow, or the neon yellow on the sides. I might have described that wrong, but it's more like a neon yellow than a full yellow, if you know what I mean. But anyways, sticking on topic and sticking with this video, I'm going to allow this to run for a few more moments, as this is the first time I've ran 60029. As I did buy this one in around October 2013, and it has been stored mostly in its box due to other commitments in my offline life, but anyways, things have changed, so I should be able to do more reviews than that for the time being anyways. Right, we're just over 4.5 minutes into this leg of the video. I'm now going to shut the power off, but as you can see, this locomotive is very, very smooth. I've actually turned the power to just below 40, and this locomotive is very responsive. This model does have opening doors and also sprung buffers, but I have shown these in previous videos, so I've omitted demonstrating this for this review, as not to sound too repetitive. But I will admit, I do have a like for the Hornby Class 60s, and I have done quite a few reviews of various liveried examples that I have. It's kind of like the Class 60 bug, if that's the right term to use. Anyways, I'm going to shut the power off. As you can see, I've only got it on 25%, and the headlights are still illuminated. Now, let's turn the power back on, and this should now show the tail lights of this excellent Hornby Class 60 model. I've got the power rating on exactly 50%. As you can see, the locomotive is quite weighty. The model does have all-wheel drive throughout, and you can just about hear the rumble via the dynamos. Just turning the power to 45% as 50%, it was quite vibrant. Anyways, whilst the model is running on the dynamos, I'm just going to take the camera and give you all a close-up of the etched nameplates. These etched nameplates are made by Fox Transfers, or Shoreplan. It's one of the two companies anyways. Actually, I'll correct myself, I believe they're actually Shoreplan. As both nameplates, the Castle Cement and the Clitheroe Castle nameplates, are both photo etched and are not printed onto this model. Just check out that light weathering on the top. Just zooming out to avoid any dazzling or blurriness. Purely an excellent model from Hornby. Right, I'm going to stop the video whilst I turn the locomotive around and I shall show off the offside and the rear cab nearest to the camera in the final clip. Before I draw this review of my model of 6029, which is one of the award-winning Hornby Class 60s. This is the final leg of the review of 6029, which is a Hornby Class 60, and this shows the offside of this particular model, and also the etched nameplates have been added to this side as well. I have picked out the footsteps on this model just to make the model look a bit better, but the tools that I used was an Edding paint pen, of which, to be honest, I was less than impressed with, so I've ordered some Tamiya enamel neutral white colour to replicate the steps on some of my other Class 6s, which should give a better finish. As most of you will know, that I do like to detail my model trains, as I like to be different, and I also like to own something unique that has a bit of personal creativeness to the model, rather than just have a model straight from the box. And with these code-free models, you do get that uniqueness to your collection. Well, it's soon time to wrap up this video, but before I do, I will show off the headlights as I select the direction on the Gauge Master Model D, which is the standard train controller that I use for all of my reviews since 2010, really, as this was the year when I actually got the Gauge Master Model D, as it was the main controller from my old Japanese N-gauge model railway. Well, it's time to wrap up this video. As you can expect, This Hornby Class 60 definitely gets a perfect 10 out of 10. Each and every time, as it's such an impressive model, it's definitely one of the best models that Hornby has made in the modern image era of diesel locomotives. The heavy-duty die-cast chassis does give plenty of weight, and this locomotive does have all-wheel drive with a central can motor, and can quite easily haul a reasonably long freight train without struggling. Although I will have to test this in theory in the future. Once I get enough wagons, I am going to perform a load test on a Hornby Class 60. And as you can probably expect, it's going to be impressive. Anyways, that's enough of my chatting for this video. I'm going to wrap this review up with a perfect 10 out of 10. If you have any comments or questions, please feel free to post them in the comment section below. And thank you for watching. Have a good week, and stay tuned for another video coming soon. Bye for now, and take care.